Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to girls high school soccer action here on Armstrong. Meadville hosting Grove City. Lon Wilson, Mike Fiorillo with you for the call tonight. Mike, it's good to be back together again.
Sure is, Lon. It's great working with you again. And last time out, these two teams played at Grove City, Lon, and it was a battle.
That's what I heard. It was rough and tumble. Right now, Meadville looking to control right out of the gate.
They ended up in a tie, went to two overtimes, and neither team scored, so the game ended in a tie.
Here's a throw in. Grove City, they're going left to right there in the black and white trim. Meadville, of course, in traditional home whites. Here's a chance for a break down the field. That's Lassane. Giving chase. She's making good control. Up ahead for Paige Yoder. Yoder, good cross. Found a cutting bulldog. That was Emma Ford. And I got to see Emma Ford playing volleyball. And let me tell you something about Emma Ford.
Oh, she plays ball sports.
You're going to see her name in the paper quite a bit for the next few years, let me tell you.
A two-sport athlete. I like that.
One of the best young volleyball players I've seen in years. Right now, Meadville still under control here.
Good pass.
Starting off in the first half, we got a whistle already.
Pulled an offside on that.
That's right, I believe Paige Yoder. No, she couldn't have been good in the infraction.
Big game here for seeding, too, for the playoffs.
And it's going to be off Yoder's. Yes, I know. You have nice group of fans underneath us showing up here for today's game.
You know, Lon, we got another beautiful night for a soccer match.
That's right, McNabb, good throw in. That's going to be off the noggin of the Grove City player. With Brittany Mattson. I'd like to thank all of our friends from Meadville and Grove City for tuning in to high school sports here in Armstrong. It is a wonderful thing to have. Now Mattson breaking down the right side, defended up by Meadville.
We've got to give kudos to our engineer, producer, director, Jeff.
That's right. He doesn't say much, but when he does, he gets right to the point. That's kind of the way we like it.
Yes, that is the way we like it.
And Jeff Corey, he does a nice job. He really has an affinity for high school sports.
He does.
And there's Grove City now with a good chance and a bump out of the box. How about that, Mike?
See that? Wasn't that nice?
That's right.
Huh?
Sidney Brown said, yeah, you're going to have to get past this elbow right here.
A little physical play by the girls on both sides, and it's going to be interesting tonight.
That's right. We're going to see a corner now, and I believe that's going to come from number 28. I'm at a bad angle here. That's Anna Williams, Jr. Williams will try to kick it down and low, defended nicely. That's a Meadville put six in the box there.
Yes, they did. Good head play, too.
And Grove City trying to advance the ball. Meadville's not going to have any of that funny business. 37-12 remaining here in the first half. That's going to be out of bounds. Meadville will get the throw in.
Both of these teams are very aggressive. You can see the aggressive play early on.
A good steal by Anna Williams, number 28.
Chance here, Lon. Oh, nice play.
The keep had to come up and make the stop, and what a good job.
She sure did. Great play right there.
By Meadville's. That's is that Nicolette Fuller?
Yes. No, I think.
No, that was a freshman, Nicolette Fuller.
The goalies, Nicolette Fuller?
No, we're trying to. Oh. That's the only goalkeeper. Oh, no. No, that was Grace Cessna that came up.
Grace Cessna, she's only a sophomore. Nicolette Fuller's a freshman. They got young goalies here at Meadville.
That's right. So Cessna showing the instinct coming up on the play.
She flew up there. Cessna flew up there.
We saw aggressive goalkeeping in Corey, and let me tell you what, that goalkeeper for Corey, that young man kept him in the game.
Did you get my little pun there on the goalie?
Yes.
Cessna flew up there.
Ah, the Cessna, yes.
Yeah, there you go.
Well, see, you named a name like Lon Wilson. I've heard every pun on my name, so puns usually drift by me. Right now, center play. I tell you, Grove City, they keep going for these outlets, Mike, and they're going to get it one of these. They're going to get behind the defense one of these days.
No doubt about it. And Brittany Mattson, number 9 for the Eagles, has been loose a couple times. They're trying to get her beyond the defense.
She has been hustling. Now, Cessna, no, they're going to take the free kick from the line. I believe that's Carolyn Adams. That's going to go out of bounds, and here's an opportunity for the Eagles. Brooke Huff, senior. No, she's going to give way to number 34, Ashley McNabb. McNabb, good throw-in. Strong throw-in.
You know, that little story about the Meadville assistant coach, Brad Snobber, and you probably know Brad pretty well, too. Works at the sports medicine with Mike Carr and so forth.
Okay.
But Brad was an assistant football coach for many years in for Meadville until his daughter got into soccer, and he turned from football to soccer, which I think is pretty cool.
That's right. I used to see him on the sidelines. Yeah. Oh, my goodness. When I was doing sideline reporting for MGW.
Right.
So in fact, some days he was the only person I could talk to. Because the score.
Yeah.
Here's Grove City again looking for advance, and Meadville's defense has to clean that up. So good pressure here by Grove City on the onset, Mike.
No doubt about that. As I said before, they're a very good team, fundamentally sound, and Meadville gave them a great game the first time, and I think it's going to be another great game tonight.
That's going to drift out of bounds. And Grove City, they're going to get a corner out of this. As Grove City's moving up their scoring unit, dropping back the midfielders. And here we go, set play coming. Off the left foot, cross coming. And that's going to drift wide. Grove City still trying to maintain control, but that's going to go out of bounds. Meadville catches a break there, Mike.
Yeah, they did. No doubt about it.
And Meadville's going to get the throw in there as well.
Good hustle up on the throw in. I really liked it.
That's right. I tell you, Lassane being boxed out.
Sidney Lewandowski, number two. A lot of hustle by Sidney getting those throw-ins and moving to play up for Meadville. Sidney Lewandowski, she's a junior. Her mother's a science teacher at Meadville High School.
Oh, a good bump up front there, and they're going to call a whistle on that one.
Yep.
Sorry, Lewandowski, before mentioned.
As I said, both of these teams are not afraid of physical play. And you know what, Lon? Actually, girls athletics has gotten very physical in all sports these days. Basketball, volleyball, I mean.
My Pee Wee team, Mike had four girls on the team. And this was a checking league. And all four of those girls were, I picked them individually because I wanted them, because they were all tough.
Yeah.
And, you know, they played, and I'll be honest with you, they were some of the best teammates and coachable players you could have on the team.
Well, no doubt.
Yeah, it, the Snyder twins, Cassie Snyder, she was on the team. Brooke Rashaki was on the team.
Girls athletics continually improved.
Oh, yeah. Katie Sheehan from Cochrane, mm-hmm. who was a phenomenal volleyball player and a phenomenal hockey player for that matter, too.
Nice.
That's going to fall into the middle now. Grove City, again, trying to advance the lead pass.
Trying to get that young lady in.
I tell you,
she can fly, I tell you. Brittany Madison can fly to number nine.
They're going to have to make sure their PF flyers are tied up tight, because Grove City is challenging
them. Doesn't she just look like an athlete, too, Brittany, number nine for Grove City? She
Absolutely.
Just looks like, you know, I get the ball free, I'm going to score. I'll tell you right now, you better guard me.
That's right, she's fast.
Yeah, she just has that look.
Well, there's also fast, and there's also player fast.
Exactly.
You've seen players like, look at a Pete Rose. Probably couldn't do no more than 6 seconds in a 40-yard dash, but could be absolutely everywhere you want him to be at any given time on the field.
Just nice to see him commentate. Fox did a great job bringing him on board for baseball.
That's it. That might stay in bounds. Yoder's going to have to give it a run. Gets nice the crossover. That's the same right now, duking it out for the ball.
And that's exactly right, because I looked – Alex Smith, defender for Grove City, midfielder.
Nice. Oh, that's off of Yoder, so good break here.
Yep.
That's right, Alexa Smith doing a tough job down low. They're going to have to break out some extra ice packs.
It's going to be a good game. I can tell both of these teams, they really want this.
That's right, 0-0, 31-15 remaining here. First half, Lon Wilson, Mike Fiorillo with the call here. We're at Bender Field at the Barco Duratz Athletic Complex. Notice I threw an extra vowel in there.
A great facility, though. It's a great facility. Soccer, football, lacrosse.
As Alexis Smith seeing her lead pass. Go for naught as Meadville's trying to control. And again, there's Grove City Eagles just trying to pace out this Bulldog defense. That's a good run there by Kaylee, I think it's Heidichuk, senior midfielder. Yeah, a little bit too strong. That was a Josie Skibinski, I believe, number eight.
Both coaches.
On the far side.
Both coaches are very active on the sidelines. Both are yelling out instructions to their players.
And hats off to both coaches. These are two very well-coached teams.
They are.
And you know what's fun? The last three, 4 years, I've gotten to see Grove City, the girls' teams from basketball, volleyball, and soccer coming up. LeSane might have a break here. No, nice out.
Very nice out. Very smart play, too.
That's right. Abby Fulkerson, goalkeeper for the Grove City Eagles. She's a junior, so she's got some experience. We've seen the Grove City teams come up from basketball, volleyball, and soccer. You know, I've had the pleasure of seeing some of these young ladies. I recognize the names. You know, they were phenomenal back when they were freshmen, you know, juniors, and, you know, now seeing some seniors. Got to see their volleyball team a few weeks ago. Tough team. Faced a tough Cash Eagles team.
Boy, they got it going again, Cash.
I tell you,
what a program they put together.
You think those are farm-raised volleyball players? I mean,
they are. Just put together an outstanding program.
And the thing, what's scary about Cash is they have a balance. You know, they have juniors, you know, freshmen, sophomores just waiting in the wings.
Wow.
Right now, we're down below the 30-minute mark. Grove City with a throw-in on the far side. Grove City again. They're in the black, white trim, and, of course, Meadville white.
White on white.
That's right. You know what's fun is you and I get to work together here on TV. It's in other worlds, it's forbidden fruit.
I know.
You know, we're not even allowed to talk to each other through our contractual arrangements.
That's it. We have to give signs and stuff.
That's right.
Good thing we know sign language.
That's right. There'd be some day when everybody, you know, somebody would just own all the radio stations and there won't be any of this. Yep. It'll be the government.
Hell, Bernie gets in. That could happen.
That's right. There's Brooke Huff now making her move down low. Meville's going to come out on the winning side of that. And again, the throw goes to Yoder. Good centering pass. Again, Meadville playing. They're playing the dump and chase as well.
Their goalie was out 20 yards from her goal.
She had no problem.
Huh?
I tell you,
that's confidence right there.
She, you know your posts, and that's a big thing about a goalkeeper in any sport is knowing your posts and your angles. And clearly, she has all the confidence in the world. So
when I like Toulon, she's one of the captains. So obviously, she's
that speaks a lot. Yeah, that speaks a lot. As a junior.
Yep. Gonna get it right there.
There's Fulkerson again. Let's see what kind of boot she has here. We've seen the short kicks. I'm impressed.
Yeah, she's an athlete.
That's a hard line drive to center. Yoder, nice dog to control, giving LeSane a chance.
You know who might be recruiting Abby? Jim Hobbaum.
That's right, field goal kicker.
Just a punter.
Punter, yeah. Yeah, all those sourpusses from Michigan.
Mm-hmm.
All I can say is aw. That's going to go out of bounds. Jessica Dennis. I'm looking for some throwing space there. Right to a Grove City competitor. But LeSane says, I compete for that.
Nice job. Got the
There's
going to
be a whistle.
Yep.
Yeah, Grove City. Maybe too aggressive by LeSane, but I think the referees are going to be well on board with the program tonight.
Yeah,
so.
They know what happened last time.
That's right. Actually, McNabb now. She'll try to fly that down court. Nice stop.
A little feed there.
Right, good job there by Jaden Urich.
Both teams have trouble getting any space. Good defense by both clubs.
And Dennis with a throw in. Yeah, they spend, I'd say now it's close to equal time. Each other's zones, 26 minutes remaining here in the first half. Nil is the score. And that's going to be out of bounds, and Meadville's going to get favor here. So this could be an opportunity. Try to get into the crowd. I can't get the number from this far away from the booth. Even with my laser eye surgery, I've not gained skills that make me all seeing. And here we go, Grove City on the run. A 3-on-3 right now developing. A little bit of room to move. And the lead pass not going to find its way. That's number 28, Anna Williams, junior. Oh, a good kick by Cessna. Now Cessna's got a foot too.
She sure does.
Wonder if I can see your mom, Donna Cessna, here in the crowd.
Yeah, that's the key to good teams too. Good goalies that can clear the ball, kick the ball well, make good saves. Athletic young ladies.
It's going to go wide.
Just like that, just to make sure you have it. That's a good play there. You're
that's
down
right.
On it, protect the goal.
Giving up the rebounds. We've
yep.
seen that with Meadville, and that Corey goalie only gave up a couple rebounds and almost cost them.
Yep.
You know, you got to, you know, some of these players right here are so skilled on the ball. Again, Meadville looking to advance Lassane. We got to see her brother. Play.
Yeah, we do.
She's a senior, I believe. If I'm not mistaken. Yeah, Alicia. Yeah, she's a senior. That's going to go out of bounds off the foot. Carolyn Adams.
Hopefully, some of these girls on both teams will play at the next level on somewhere.
You hope so. The opportunities are wonderful.
They are.
Now, Ashley McNabb. Getting ready for a throw. We've had some substitutions. I just see Brookoff chasing off for Grove City. We'll get replacements as they field her into the play. Yoder. Challenged nicely, but Meadville will hold possession. And back and forth again at the midfield. 23-40 remaining. First half moving along at a good clip. Oh, wow, loose ball in the middle. Look who was there, Brittany Mattson,
yep.
who we were talking about earlier. Just finding the pathway to the ball. And that's going to be off Grove City player, and I think Meadville, yes, they are going to get the throw in. Nice crowd again here for tonight's game.
Yeah.
Beautiful evening here in Meadville, Pennsylvania.
Yeah, good crowd, beautiful weather, two good teams. High school girls, soccer.
And right now, Meadville being challenged inside.
I'm trying to think what girls did 40 years ago. What did they do?
Basketball. Basketball was
about it.
Basketball, track. Here's the same. I tell you, she can outpace number 14, and a good job by Alexis Smith.
Well, basketball was
staying
a different
tough.
Game back then.
Field hockey. You're right, it was a little bit more archaic and rudimentary, as even, like I said, with the girls' ice hockey program to start up, Mercyhurst is, I've gone up there, phenomenal program.
That's what I mean. Yeah.
And you watch some
girls' soccer, you know, the American Cup team, whatever you call it, the Olympic team, whatever that
such
thing
a,
they have, World Cup.
Such a big fan.
Oh, my favorite player is Abby Wambach. I think she's awesome.
There's the same with an opportunity. Can't dribble past the defender for Grove City. You got a number on that defender, I give her credit. I believe that might have been Josie Skabinski back there, number 8.
Yeah, it was. It's a single-digit number. You're exactly right.
That was a tough draw. Lived up to it.
Here she is again.
Yeah, Meadville.
She's not afraid to put her face in there.
That's right. There's Alexa Smith looking for an outlet. That's going to be out of bounds. Yep, on the Meadville player's foot.
Really made our society better. I thought the girls' competitiveness, aggressiveness, and our society's better off for them.
Well, it's just the fact of just wanting to play. I mean, even as, you know, young man as I was, an 8-year-old, you know, there's a couple girls in the neighborhood who wanted to play baseball, and we're like, why not?
Right.
You know, we're like, whatever. We play with them on the field next to the convalescent home. Why wouldn't they play
exactly. You
know, on our little league team? It was, you know, Mike, it's always the grown-ups that ruin it for everybody.
Exactly.
So.
Kids always get along.
There we go.
Oh, nice little footwork there.
Oh, here's a break here, Mike. Cessna's going to challenge, and smartly does.
She does it with no fear. She
didn't
rush herself, took her time, and just got the ball.
That's right. No panic at all.
Not at all.
She's got nerves of steel.
Been there before.
You played goalkeeper? No, your daughter played quite a few years, didn't she?
My daughter?
Yeah.
No, she played volleyball.
Volleyball, okay, that's right.
She was the center. Nice
play! Right now, Meadville trying to break out. Grove City pinning him down to the 20-minute mark. We're halfway through the first already, and so far, nothing gives here, Mike.
She played a little girl soccer, and she was funny. She played defense. She liked volleyball better, so she said she didn't have to run as much.
I actually led her 2 years in a row in volleyball.
Nice.
When I was, you know, 190 pounds and
Good sport.
I love volleyball.
Yeah, great sport.
I remember we played an exhibition game against a school for the deaf down in Pittsburgh.
Wow.
And took everything for absolute granted. Going into this, we were our conference champions in we were a private school, actually, but we were very – remember George Ackles played for UNLV? Mm-hmm. He was on that team. I went to school with him in high school.
Jeez.
So, I mean, he was 6 foot, I think, nine then.
He was huge.
We went out there, and we got pasted 3 games in a row. And, in fact, I don't even think we mustered more than 5 points in all three matches. And our coaches were laughing at us, saying that, what you guys take for granted, other people.
How about that young man who plays football
don't.
At Cambridge Springs?
You know, there's actually, yes, you're right, there's Cambridge Springs, and there's.
Oh, my God, that kid is what? Disabled a little bit, and he's done a great job.
We had a volleyball player, young man out in Maplewood. Mm-hmm. Had some, he was there, he could not sweat.
Wow.
You know, he was, it was a glandular part.
Right.
It was a great spokesman for it, too, in that condition. But you see him come out of the game. Oh, here we go, Meadville.
Got a shot here.
Looking to advance the ball.
Passing it to herself. Looking towards the middle. She can get it.
Lassane hit the cross. Oh, what a pickup by the goalkeeper.
Wow.
Are you kidding me, Lassane?
Wow.
Got the crossover from Bennick.
I thought there was no way that was not going to go in. What a great.
Abby Fulkerson, are you kidding? That was like lightning reflexes. They call her the Flash. Probably pay her $2 million a year contract. She deserves it.
That'd be a replay.
That was like, she picked it up off the post. Like, what?
Oh, wow, what a great play. Great hands.
Had she not have done that.
Eye coordination was tremendous.
Meadville might have had themselves an easy goal. I think Lassane would want that one back again. But the cross from Bennick, number 11. Did you see the hustle on Alexis Bennick?
Oh, yeah.
Sophomore. So there was our... that's what you ate for here in soccer.
You know, both teams didn't have to be told a lot about this game. Both teams got up for this game.
Look at the same. Look at the ball control.
Isn't that amazing?
Passing
nice
off.
Nice pass outside, too.
That's right. It
nice
down
block
to Bennick.
By 35 for Grove City. Great.
Yeah, Corey Boshin.
Yeah, what a great play.
Nice job. 17:35 remaining, and that was the best scoring opportunity of the evening.
Corey's only a sophomore. Boy, I guess some good young players on both sides.
Yes, they do. But Lassane, the foot control, to make that lead pass up was unbelievable. Here comes Grove City looking for an outlet. Oh, wow, just misses Brittany Madsen. Good job to get that ball up.
You know, just due to both teams, both
Williams.
Of their goalies are very active.
Yeah.
You know, both sides, both goalies are not afraid to come out.
They've been around too long. If you set back into your net, you're giving up every angle.
That's right.
You know, you see how big that is when you're down at the floor level. Well, powerful throw in. Alexa Smith, she's having a nice game on defense for Grove City. Drawing a tough assignment, too. Basically, it's regardless same. And Alicia, I'll tell you, she's just impressive. It's going to be a long lead, but nobody there. Yoder closing in as well as Lassane. Good job to get rid of it. Again, Grove City looking just to, in some sense, of control. Good stop there. The Eagles.
Yep, go back.
Yeah, they'll try to advance it down. That's going to stay in bounds. Down to the 15:58 mark here, first half, 0-0. Lon Wilson, Mike Fiorillo with you. You say our name all the time because it gives us a boost of confidence.
You know, no score, Lon, but a very competitive game. Very competitive, a lot of action. Both goalies are tremendous athletes. It's really going to take a great play to get a goal tonight, I think.
Oh, that's the truth. Nice early game tonight, too, 6:30 start. You got to like that.
I think they did that because of the baseball playoff game coming on right after this.
that could be.
You know, you want to get the West Coast involved.
You never know the affiliates.
That's right.
You got to take care of the affiliates.
Yep.
Here we are, Grove City again, marching down. Good footwork. That's off a defender from Meadville. The shot will not go through.
If Meadville can get it quick.
That's right. That was like a scene from The Hobbit. You shall not pass. Yeah, Jessica Dennis doing a good job, number five for Meadville.
Push up, Dean.
Hanging tough because Grove City's challenging. They like to throw that lead pass in.
Both players right there gave a little bit.
Yeah.
You know, a good no call by the official, too.
I tell you, Alexis Panic.
I'm really enjoying this game because this is aggressive soccer.
Yeah, those two players off the, I believe that's Corey Boshin and Alexis Bennick, who've drawn the assignment against each other.
Yep.
They are just playing tough.
There we go. There we go.
Look, this Yoder may have a chance and coming up.
Good try, though. Great, great chance.
Again, Fulkerson, eyes on the ball. Good work. Now down to the 14-minute mark. And Grove City try to move that one up and out.
Nice.
It's Ashley
play.
Chess.
Yeah, nice little play.
That's right. Back to Chess. He's going to have the throw in. Going to look to the middle.
Notice both teams get that throw in quickly. Quick. If there's a chance of getting quick, they just throw that thing in.
That's right. Ashley McNabb and
got a couple subs coming in for each team.
That's right. Paige Yoder. Looks like she might be getting a break.
17 for Meadville.
That's Kaylee Baum. Kayla Baum, sophomore Baum. Coming in.
Yep, not a young player.
Ouch. That's why they get paid millions of dollars out there.
Both teams are not giving the names.
That kick
awesome.
Went right to the side.
This
Jessica Dennis, she didn't even flinch.
Not at all.
Well, Grove City 3-on-3. They had a chance.
Good play
nicely.
Right there.
There's the mistake they might be waiting for, Mike. Here she is. Shot, score.
Oh.
Brittany Mattson, you made the call earlier to keep an eye on her. You get an extra dollar bill in your paycheck. And Cessna just hung out to dry.
Yeah, she came out the best she could, and Brittany just put a nice shot on that and went right over the top of it.
That's what they were waiting for.
Yep. She's a scorer for the Grove City Eagles.
That's right. That'll come at the 13:09 mark. Brittany Mattson, she'll get her name in the paper. I tell you, the hustle pays off.
Sure does.
And here we are, 1-0 Grove City. With the lead here in the first half, and Grove City picking up right at midfield. Give and go from Skabinski.
Oh, nice little crossover there.
And again.
Trying to get her again.
That's right, Mattson breaking. Tell you, a little bit softer on that, and she would have had another opportunity,
she
Mike.
Definitely. Great crossover.
That's right, Cessna will get rid of it. Now Meadville looking for the equalizer. I tell you, Fulkerson's been tough tonight for Grove City. Oh, look at this. Mattson showing off some foot skills. But Sydney Brown said, I've seen enough of that foot skills. So familiar, too. I mean, these teams are familiar.
Yes, they are. Nice boot.
Might be a little bit too far, but still pressing. On the far side, number 11, Alexis Bannock. Again,
nice
Grove
pass.
City looking for a lead. Mattson, she's in the middle hanging out.
Trying to give it to her again. That's what they do, don't they?
That's what
nice
they do.
Nice play there by Cessney. I tell you, they look for her all the time, Dodge, streaking down the middle.
Absolutely. You also had Brooke Huff coming down in the middle as well.
I almost gave it back to her.
That's right, in Cessna. She's getting some work. She'll be challenged, I'm sure, more often throughout this game. 11:24 remaining, ticking down to the 10-minute mark. Yeah, in Grove City, not too many mistakes back on the defensive handling. Nothing.
Exactly right.
Nothing extremely.
They take the ball and they don't just give it up.
That's right.
For someone to pass to.
With this nice lead ahead, that's Anna Williams.
Oh, good defensive play right there.
Yeah, great challenge by Meadville.
Good defensive play.
Yeah, that was number 12 coming up.
Who is
there
that?
Is no number 12. You see number 12?
No, we don't have a 12 on that.
Well, sometimes we just have to go with number 12. That's, I'm literally sticking my head out the window. There's a chance in the middle. Matson gets the shot. Cessna reaches up, gets on the ladder.
There you go. I can turn it a little bit.
Tell you, Matson, she's ready to put some barbecue sauce on that one. Came right down to her foot.
Number 12 is McKenna Mercer.
There we go.
For the Dogs.
I think we did see number 12 out there in the corner.
Yep.
Always want to give credit where credit is due. Like I said, some of the angles here, folks, we apologize.
McKenna's a sophomore, too, not a young Bulldog out there. One thing, the coaches on both sides are not afraid to play the young kids in this big game either.
Now we're seeing Skibinski now here on the near side of the field. Gross City is going to lose that.
Yeah.
Rich Kiebert down there to make the call with authority.
Good official. Let the kids play.
He is. Wow, look, we got some wholesale subs coming in.
Meadville again.
Oh, me
subbing away. Kind of like that, though, what he's done. He's almost like a line change in hockey, line. He puts four in at a time.
Well, Paige Yoder has been working the left side of this field. She's almost got a mark dug into the left hash mark here.
She just came back in, too. She had a little break. Let's see if that helps her a little bit. If we can get the ball down there.
Again, there's Matson working into the corner for Grove City. Gets a crossing center at Cessna.
Boy, that Matson's a tough play. That's a hard kick there to execute like that. A corner kick like that on goal. Cessna was up to the challenge. She was ready. Boy, that great play by her, too. Some goalies wouldn't have expected that.
That's right, and that's going to be knocked out of bounds. I believe it might be off Brown. We'll see what the call is. Yes, Meadville will get the kick out.
This is really a great game.
Oh, it has
really
been.
Really good play by both teams. Young ladies on both sides, very well, fundamentally sound.
Now Sydney Brown getting ready for a kick out of her own end. Right now, Grove City, they might have a shot here. Meadville, good hustle to work that out. And right back it goes, and there's Skibinski again. She knows her name's being called. Skibinski again with the steal.
Mm-hmm. He's cheating up a little bit now.
So in the middle goes. Anna Williams has been hustling.
There's a nice play.
Good quarterbacking. Kick. Oh, Cessna.
Save.
Has to keep her eyes open there.
Exactly. That shot may not look difficult, but it was because it was a floater up high.
Well, you know what they say in hockey and soccer, put the ball on net and good things will happen.
Yep.
So 7:48 right now, 1-0 Grove City. Eagles with the lead here in Meadville, Pennsylvania. That's right. That makes the bus ride more fun.
Good play.
That's a good foot. That's number 6, Cameron Skibinski. We got two Skibinskis out there.
Well, I'll tell you why. She made a good play.
I thought that was the number 8, Josie Skibinski, but there you go.
She's a sophomore, Cameron.
Blasted that ball out of there.
Good foot.
Well, here's Meadville now trying to do some work.
Grove City is pinching in and they're beating Meadville to the ball right now.
That's what you got to keep hope for, is that one opportunity.
He goes again. Got an aggressive play.
This match between Lestane and Alexis Smith tonight, them two have been just a little bit of pushing going on both sides.
And both sides are evil guys yelling and screaming at the officials, but it's both ways. And you know what I like is they're not calling it over.
They're
letting them play. Exactly.
That's right. Everybody needs to calm down now. We used to say in the military, lighten up, Francis. 6:30. But see, then again, we don't have any daughters out there.
No, so. If my daughter was playing for me, I'd be yelling. I have in a pet.
6:20, the Boo Birds rain down again.
I yelled at George a few times when I thought he missed a carry or something in volleyball.
There you go, Paige Yoder now, trying to make some work. I know I got a grandson in hockey just starting it. I'm just trying to be a side, being, almost 10 years, I think I was on the ice before. before, now staying off the ice. You know, I should probably get one of those Rhino darts or a Valium before going
it's
in.
It's harder to watch than play.
It is. There you go. Whoa, his punches it ahead. That's right. Grove City breaking down the left side. Oh, the center broken up by Cessna.
Great play by Cessna. She
the
watched
defense
that whole
cleans
way.
That up.
Yep. Came out, Cessna cut the angle down.
Trying to get the number there. On the player from Grove City because that was some hustle down the field. And again, I wish we'd had a monitor. Jeff Corey could have helped us out, but maybe budget cuts.
Well, you said they were cutbacks.
Yeah.
That's what he told me.
Well, there we go now. 5 minutes remaining, first half, 1-0, Grove City. Already a spirited competition, Mike.
Jeff did tell me, seriously, they're working on the HD for next year.
Oh, that'd be great.
Yeah.
Now, Sidney Lewandowski back in the game, number two for Meadville. Again, Grove City with some pressure.
And they're walking up their defense, too. Look at it, Grove City.
Yes, they are. And there's a cross. Oh, right in the middle. Off the post.
Yep.
Madsen again. Cessna barely got enough of that to get it up to the post. But Madsen, I'm telling you.
Flies to the net. When that ball's shot, she flies there.
You think they may want to put a shadow on her?
I'm telling you. You know, she's behind you, and you turn, and she's in front of you.
Quick.
Yep, exactly. So she's hard to mark.
Boy, Cessna just staying tough again. Off the post. I take both goaltenders have had the post help out. Now the same, but a little bit of room here. Challenged up again. There we go. And again, Alexa Smith.
Alexa Smith. She is a tough cookie.
She is just
she's the tough cookie. That's the only way to put it.
I'm going to vote she gets an extra Capri Sun in the locker room because she has been
telling you.
Absolutely tough on the play.
You heck of a strong safety. It's right. Eagles need a player on their football team.
There we go. She's that might stay in.
She
yeah, you're right.
Down. She's tough.
Here we go now. Meadville get the throw in. 3:36 remaining. I'd like to thank everybody joining us from Meadville and Grove City. Again, thank you to Armstrong for bringing us high school soccer action. Now Meadville finally cleans up. Gets it to the near side. That's hustling for the ball is Lewandowski. Yoder's not going to get a chance because Ashley McNabb says, I don't believe in chances. Here's Grove City turning the tables. They've got three on two right now, Mike.
Yep, here we go.
Chance to spread the defense. They got to get back, and there's a center, and in the net it goes. Are you kidding me? Brittany Madsen.
Nice teamwork right there.
Took the feet, I think, by Anna Williams. Yes. I'm not sure.
No,
but
you're right, it is. And what great teamwork. They had that set up really well. As you said, Lon, it was a three on two. Great passing by Grove City. No chance for Cessna on that. None.
That's right. Meadville's defense got set back again in the quickness again for Grove City. Capitalizing on it. Now, they played to a draw in their first meeting.
Yeah, went to double overtime and ended up being a tie. So there's hope that Meadville can get a couple goals yet.
Oh, Meadville has the talent. They just haven't had the time and, you know what, the pressure, you know, on Fulkerson, the goalkeep. I'm looking down below and I see Z. He's a legend here at Meadville.
He is. He's,
you know, he's retired, but he can't stop hanging around.
No.
You take the teacher out of the school, but you can't take the school out of the teacher.
Told me that.
He corrected one of my assignments the other day just because he had nothing better to do.
That was nice of him.
Yeah, it was. Now 2:24 remaining.
Plans of a statue being erected somewhere in town.
Yes. It's going to go out of bounds. Grove City here with a late opportunity. They're going to get a throw in. Coming up is Ashley McNabb. And down it goes to who else but Madsen. And she's going to get the throw in. No, Madsen's going to let somebody else take that.
I think when you had your good sports, didn't he make a few appearances?
No.
He never made a guest appearance.
No, he did. Well, he made... He did photo bombs.
Okay.
He would sneak into the back and try to get in, you know.
Okay.
We had a lot of people try to do that. There we go, Alexa Smith.
She's a good player.
Yeah, with the throw in.
She is a very good player for the
Eagles.
Look
at that. Technical, perfect.
Exactly.
Yeah, Madsen.
Brittany again, huh? She's something else, that Brittany.
Wow. taken
down. She's a good player.
Brooke Huff just.
She's only a junior. She's back again for the Eagles next year. Wow. So the opposition's not happy about that.
I don't know if you saw it or not. Brooke Huff, number 10. Just dumped a medium player about 30 seconds ago right in the middle. No whistles. But hey, they get tangled up, it's going to happen.
They figure they're going to play hard, and if you blow a whistle, fine. If not, oh well.
It's right now down to a minute remaining here in the first half, 2-0 Grove City. And Meadville's going to get the throw in. They got to be careful here, Mike.
Yeah, they don't want to give up a late goal. You're exactly right. Played a good first half, two goals you gave up, but you know, that was just great plays by Grove City.
That's right, you got to shake those off. Trying to get that down to Paige Yoder. That's going to be off a Grove City player. No.
Paige Yoder, a junior from Meadville.
That's right. Insane, looking for the ball. Down to 32 seconds. That's the whole thing is, you know what, sometimes it's the way the ball bounces, and Meadville has not had that opportunistic moment. Now 20 seconds remaining. That's going to be off of Grove City. Meadville's going to have to hustle if they have any hope of putting a shot on net. And out it goes.
Winding down the first
half. Right, down to 5 seconds. Grove City's just going to get rid of
that's
that,
right there.
Courtesy of Alexa Smith. That's it, folks. Tell the tape. 2-0 Grove City Eagles taking on Meadville on their home turf. So we're going to be back second half, folks, in just a moment. Hang in there.
Talking to Dominic Dorenzo, Lon, about this contest.
That's right. Dominic Dorenzo in the booth here as we get set to start the second.
It's and, like the old days on Monday Night Football. We have famous people visit the booth. We have
Dominic. Right. That's right. I think Mercier, you said, was at the top to start it off. And again, Meadville defense challenged already.
Yeah, Meadville switching players around a little bit, trying to get something going. Good idea.
That's right. It's a good angle. See you later, Dom. Take care. Always
sure,
good
Dom.
To see Dom Dorenzo, who works out of Teal.
Yeah.
Good man. Did sports as a sports director at Meadville Tribune for many years.
Still does some writing for them.
Yeah, he
events.
Was. That's what I miss is when he wrote his columns. And he always liked to see the opinion pieces.
Yes.
There's Mattson. All the way down there again. Brittany Mattson. Two goals. One at the 1309 mark and the other at the 259 mark. So she's having a whale of a game.
Yep, Meadville needs to come back and try to get a couple goals and see what happens.
That's right, 39-minute mark hit. We are well underway here in the second half. Lon Wilson, Mike Fiorillo with you here on Armstrong. And there's a collision. No whistle. Even up, centering pass. And a quick shot that's got to go left. And Cessna will have to clean that one up. Number 10, Brooke Huff. She had all the time. She actually had a few seconds to work with there.
You know, both officials are letting the play go, which is really good and keeps the pace going.
Right, they've had some whistles when they thought it got a little excessive.
Yeah, right.
You know, they've...
But they're not blowing it every second to stop the pace of the game. Or the flow of the game, as some people would say.
Right, again, in Grove City right now, a little bit more pressure. And Meadville, they'll get the throw in here. That's Lewandowski.
Meadville coaches are saying, get it going, let's go.
That's right, give you our team time to set.
We got a young lady for Grove City tying her sneaker.
That's right, taking her
Play
time.
Goes on, yep. Trying to hide back there.
Got to get it done right. Number 9, Brittany Mattson. She's I'll do whatever I want. I scored two goals.
Yeah, look at her. Maybe I can hide here, too. Kneel down, they won't see me. Get another one. She looks. She's going to be looking for the hat trick in this second half.
That's right. I expect to see that $30 hat of yours on the field. There's a big kick downfield and trying to cover right now is number 12. Did you say that was Mercier? I didn't have that one on my roster that I got.
Here it is, number 12 right here. Mackenzie Mercer, right? Or Mercier, what do you say?
I think Dorenzo said Mercier. I want to make sure.
Oh, I think you're right. That's what he said. He would know.
I think that's right. He's college trained and educated. So 37-30 mark, 2-0 Grove City with the lead. And there's a whistle. Grove City's going to get the free kick, and now there's more.
His daughter's on the team. She's ninth grade.
Now there's some more aggressive whistles.
Dominic's daughter's a ninth grader on this team.
I've got to see both of the Dorenzo kids through their very young stages.
Nice.
So that's It's always fun to watch.
Did they go on the set with you guys once in a while?
Luca did, actually. Yes, they both did. Dom would bring them to the sets. That's going to go to the stands. One lucky fan's going to go home with a souvenir.
Good influences being you guys on the set.
Yeah, Dom. Dom and his... They gave me a no-talk rule. I wasn't allowed to talk or make eye contact with the children. So they're like, we don't want them damaged. I think they're PBS trained. So, and I always made a mockery of the English language. So 36-25, good folks, though, the Lorenzos. Do miss them being around.
Here we go, chance for Meadville.
That's Mercier coming down low. She's got to get it in. Can't get the crossover to Lassane. She was camped out. And Grove City caught a break there.
That change almost worked, putting her up there.
That's right, Fulkerson.
She's a sophomore, too. She had a nice jet of speed going up to that right side. Just couldn't get the pass over.
They're going to take their time getting it up, and there's the long outlet. But out of bounds by Grove City.
Eagle trying to put the pressure on.
That's what you don't like to see, and that's headed right out of bounds by number 34, McNabb. She had a good first half. Playing tough, and there's a miscue. And Meadville keeping the pressure on right now, but Grove City cleaning it up in their defensive zone.
Oh, that's a good play.
Now at the top, nice work by number 18, Carolyn Adams.
We get a kick to the middle here.
Cross coming.
Nice attempt, nice try, good hustle.
There's nothing doing. And there we are, 35-minute mark. 5 minutes already gone. Look at that kick. Fulkerson just, at this point, it's just showing off, Mike.
Yeah, she got a good leg. Question about that. Meadville's putting the pressure on right now.
That's exactly what Meadville needed. And there's, they got their feet tangled up. No whistle.
No whistle.
That's going to be out of bounds of Meadville. That's the case. They might get the corner kick here.
That's what I was thinking.
And that's a huge opportunity right now. Carolyn Adams, they need two to get this all knotted up here. And I'm looking to see where Lassane is positioned. Yep, she's right there in the middle.
She is. She's up close.
And that's going to come across the middle and far. Good header out. Towards the net. And Meadville trying to settle down a series of headers. That's going to be worth 3 points, and that's out of here.
I tell you what, that was a great attempt. What a nice header that was.
Everybody in on the act there.
No, it wasn't for a lack of hustle on that one.
Now Meadville again with the short outlet, Mike. I don't, I'm telling you what, I'd be giving it to Fulkerson to kick the hell out of it. But then again, I'm not the coach of a high school.
Meadville right now is pinching up to get some opportunities here, Lon.
Yeah, they are. And there's a cross to Lassane. It just misses her.
Nice play there.
And nice defense back.
Yep.
And I want to say that's number 34, Ashley McNabb, covering the
back.
Lon,
you couldn't have said that better. That just missed Lassane. I mean, that was about a half an inch off her foot.
Oh, look at that. A miscue. Oh. Fulkerson there to clean it up.
Meadville. Much better with the pressure right now.
Sorry, Fulkerson.
Again, to come up.
No problem getting rid of that. Grove City will have the opportunity for the throw-in. And you're right, Meadville just getting aggressive in the center of the midfielders.
Last 4 minutes of the opening second half, Meadville's dominated possession. They need to do their down two goals.
And again, Grove City now inching down. One throw in at a time, but hey, whatever gets you there. Again, 2-0. There's a throw in and trying to head it back upfield. And the Bulldogs. Man, can't break the pressure. That was Anna Williams, number 28 for Grove City. We called her number a lot in the first half. I think she might have been part of those two assists to Mattson. That's going to go down low. Meadville's got to clear that out of there. They're in a dangerous area right now, Mike.
Yeah, they are. They're trying to make a play, too. They want to get it out and dribble it up, get on the offensive. Grove City's hemming him in right now.
And look at that. Grove City dropped back one extra defender, seeing Lassane all alone, one-on-one.
Yep.
with Alexa Smith. Right there, that's presence of field and presence of coaching. Nice work.
Definitely, and you got the two-goal lead.
They don't want to give away the breakaway.
Exactly. You don't have to be super aggressive on offense right now. Evil has to be aggressive on offense.
That's going to be out of bounds. Yes. Corey Boshin will get the throw in, number 35. And a kick ahead.
The Eagles throw in, I think. Yep.
It's right out of bounds. And it's Lewandowski now. And good throw in.
Nice play right there.
So Carolyn Adams playing tough soccer right now. That's the pressure they need right there. Aggressive play.
You playing. You playing. There's no whistle.
Oh, look at this.
Got a chance. Got a chance.
In the same now. Got to go left footed. Shot yes. Score.
What a great play by Meadville.
And Carolyn Adams, number 18, stuck with that play
yes,
through two,
did.
Three, four players.
An outstanding play.
Got it ahead to Lassane in 30-59.
And she made a great pass to Lassane. Lassane with some fancy footwork. Oh, what a great team play right there. Again, Meadville showing they're not going to give up here. They're down, but they're not out. Plenty of time left, 30 minutes. What a great soccer game by both schools.
Right at the 30-59 mark.
So big goals have been scored by the two big guns of each team.
That's right.
But what a great play. You're a big assist in the work to get it.
Sorry, Carolyn Adams.
What a great
sophomore. Just imposed her will.
A sophomore.
That's
both
right.
Both of these teams have outstanding young talent. Both of them.
Now, Meadville looking for the equalizer now.
You're going to see Grove City rev up their offense.
I don't think
bit.
You're going to see Grove City sit back and wait.
Not now.
Look at this. Mattson may have a shot. Tries to work through the defense.
Good play there. Kick it to the side. Against he kicks it to the side. Yoder, Ullman job twice.
Sorry, Lewandowski over there to help out. And somebody might be, somebody might got a stinger.
Play continues, though.
I'm sorry, was that, was Ashley Chess. I believe number 7. If I'm not mistaken, I can't get a, I got a smudged window here in front of me. You know, I know Windex is approved by
Well, that's usually Ed's side during the game, so.
That's right. Yeah, is he breathe a lot? Is he cough on this?
He might.
I don't want Ed germs. That's all right. I'm good there.
You can slide that down here.
I don't want to.
Yeah, you got Ed germs on that side.
So I'm going to take a couple extra vitamins when I get home now. 20-47.
Need a vitamin B14 shot.
That's right. Go to Cheech Marin. Good to hear him getting a shot on the mic.
That's a good job. Well, he knows the game. He coaches it, too.
That's right. There we go.
You can see the Meadville young ladies. Just a little spirit is way up now.
Oh, that's a big lift.
It is. Getting that
is that
goal.
A new goaltender in there for Meadville?
It looks like
I think it is, yeah.
I think they changed, yeah.
I don't know if it's a change in jersey.
So maybe they're changing the two young goalies, maybe each play a half.
That's I'm looking at the set. That might be Nicolette Fuller now. Because I think we have different jerseys. I think in all powder blue or light blue.
Yeah, I think you're right. Goder, that's a nice move.
Cessna.
Go check it out.
Sorry, we need to get the facts straight here. If anybody would know, it would be the people in the booth. There's Mattson getting checked up nicely. Ouch. That's going to be a whistle. Lewandowski coming in aggressively. And here's a chance, number 19 going down, Kylie Hidacek. That's right. I made the keen observation, I get extra bonus points.
Right on, Nicolette Fuller is in goal for the Dogs.
Wow, I tell you what, there's some Brittany Mattson
and you know what?
Carolyn Adams just got tangled up.
The Meadville coaching staff, not only did they change goalies.
Look at this, there she is again.
But they also changed some players from back to front.
Yes, they did. They mixed it up and it's worked.
It's really worked. And you know what? That's good coaching. That is good coaching to mix it up a little bit if things aren't going well.
Carolyn Adams right now is just.
I'll tell you what that does too, Lon.
Skills as a sophomore.
What that does too, if you're a player, a coach like that, you're going to be ready to play because the coach is going to mix it up. So you got to be ready.
Absolutely.
That's exciting as a player. You know you're going to get an opportunity.
And 27-45 remaining here in the second half. 2-1 Grove City with the lead here in Meadville.
Exciting soccer game. Lon said good crowd down below.
It is. Good crowd. I'd say I see people walking by with snacks.
Yeah, they had snack places open.
Most facilities you go to, the broadcast teams are showing certain courtesies.
And a big bake sale down there, too.
Right now, Meadville just looking for some room to get that aggressive edge back again. Grove City had a couple opportunities here later.
Meadville wants to get the tying goal, but they don't want to give one up in the process. They're going to play smart. Got plenty of time with 27 minutes left. Again.
That's it.
Man, they just kick it to her and let her go.
That's right. They want to see what's going to happen. Yeah, Nicolette Fuller, she's going to be challenged here in the second half.
She's a speedster.
Here we go, Meadville just trying to assemble something here. Now Grove City, again, Lassane, nice advance. Far side.
He's got a chance. You got
in the middle it goes. Nice Mercer play. Was there.
There we go again.
And a long kick.
Nice kick. I like that.
I tell you, again, Carolyn Adams is just imposing her will on the field. You know number 18 is out there.
I like that kick.
Look at this again. Right with it. Lassane now.
Another sophomore for Meadville Adams.
They're going to call that a handball.
They got a really good sophomore class out there.
Meadville. Yeah, they do.
A real good. Four or five young girl sophomores that are really good players.
Got the two goalkeepers one's a freshman.
Yeah, the one in net now is a freshman.
Sessa's a sophomore.
Adams is a sophomore. She's got a strong leg. I'd like to see her move up with about 10 more yards and boom, that baby. I'm going to put the ball and the goalie in the net. She has a strong leg.
It's Corey Boshin now. Get ready for the throw-in.
Because females today, as you know, Lon, they do lifting and everything else. They get their whole body in shape these days.
Absolutely. Now three Army Rangers now. Females successfully completed the program.
Wow. That's great.
That's right. This new sub-in for Meadville, number 8. That's Carrie Schnauber.
Yep.
Another sophomore.
Not a sophomore.
That's
Wow, I'm looking at this roster.
He has at least
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Maybe 11.
11 sophomores on this team. He's got 11 sophomores, 2 freshmen, 3 freshmen.
I'm looking here. I got 1 senior.
That's it. Oh, this is going to be a heck of a team
next
year.
And that's Alicia Lassane. You ain't kidding. Right now, big advantage here for Grove City, Mike. They got the corner.
You know who you got to mark right now. You got to find number what?
Number 9.
Exactly. You got to find her, and they are right there. They're marking her, but they got to stay with her.
That's right. You got Ashley McNabb down low as well to put her in as a presence. Long kick. Nobody on the far side or the near side here to collect it. And I think Meadville's going to get the throw, and they do.
Trying to hurry up because they got some time down here.
That's right. They want to get that downfield as quickly as possible. 24 minutes remaining. And sometimes that takes 24 minutes just to get one shot. So every second right now is precious. Wow, there's a fall down. Meadville can't capitalize. Good center field play by Grove City. Here's Mara Miles checking in, number 20 for Grove City. She's going to get into the action.
Whistle.
That's right.
Keep your elbows down.
That's right. And that's, I think, Carrie Schnauber. You know, hooked out with that goal as well.
Interesting is we didn't hear that one time when we did the boys game last week.
That's right. That's Rich Keeper.
Keep your elbows down. I like it.
Rich Keeper tells you to keep your elbows down. You do it.
Yeah.
So I've seen him pin a couple guys years back playing hockey. Heck of a hockey player. Nicest guy you'd ever want to meet.
His daughter was the girls' coach for a couple years before she moved. She was a great player. For
yes, absolutely. 23-minute mark now. 2-1 Grove City. Still with the lead.
His son just came back from China. Does work with the Carolina basketball team.
No kidding.
They took a trip to China. He went with them.
I'll be darned. Another little collision. Meadville try to take advantage of that right now. A little bit of pushing.
He has a little kick
going on. And who else takes charge of Carolyn Adams?
Nice job. The goalie again.
That's right. She's had a nice game.
She's had a real good game.
That's right. Abby Fulkerson. junior for this Grove City team now. It's a 1-on-3. That's
that's good defense.
The odds were not ever in her favor.
No.
And that's going to be off a Meadville player, though. Wow, that's the hustle that'll get you there.
That's right. So she's outnumbered 1-3, which she ended up getting a corner kick for her team.
That's right. Anna Williams coming in. Matson, of course, down low already. Ashley McNabb setting up. See, they're going to put more players here on the far side.
That's a good move.
That's right. They got Mara Miles there as well. So let's see what kind of a folderall we have here. Taking her time. You waiting for a whistle or?
Referee's
I think the one player has to be out. Yeah, back to the box. Yep, they're going to do a quick in. Then back up to the top. There's your center. Stonewalled in the middle. Defense stout by Meadville. Left-footed kick. It's going to go wide.
What a nice play, though, by Grove City. A set play. They ran that to pretty well.
That's right. Meadville staying strong right in the middle where they needed to be. So 21-24 remaining. Here in the first half, Meadville still down 1 to Grove City. Grove City, nice job. We're holding up for subs here now. I can't see who's going out. Carolyn Adams is heading out of the game. I think Grove City's probably cheering that move.
Yeah, I think so.
There's Elisa the Saints. She's played every minute, I believe.
Nice little pass there. We can't get to it. Yoder
right.
Couldn't get there.
Tried to stretch it out. Yeah, Paige Yoder on the far side now. We haven't called her much here in the second half.
No, we haven't.
Now the same, sticking in the middle there, Grove City. Collecting and controlling. That's going to be back down the field for Meadville. That's in the game number 16. That's Cassidy Boughton, another sophomore. Who would have guessed?
There's so many sophomores on this team for Meadville.
Sorry, Miles now tries to get it up midfield.
Coming into this game with a record of 6 wins, 4 ties, and 3 losses.
That's right. Good
four
footwork.
Ties. That's crazy.
Now Lassane trying to dish it off. They got a chance here. Lassane's got an edge. He can't get it across. I believe that was Paige Yoder. Had the give and go opportunity.
It was.
Now we're below 19 minutes remaining here. Grove City will kick it away. Fulkerson. That's right, they're going to do the short kick. Try to break out, maybe eat up more time off the clock, Mike. I'm sure that might be a byproduct of this.
People moving up. I like that. Coach is moving his players up.
Again, the opportunities might be few and far between. Fulkerson says, excuse me while I get this and I kick it away.
Pressure here by the Eagles.
Oh, there's a hard call. That's going to be a whistle. She shrugs it off. Sydney Brown's like, all right, my bad.
Little smile on her face, like, huh? I'm a sophomore. You'll know who I am by the time I'm a senior.
Anna Williams right now, they got a great opportunity here, Mike. Meadville trying to set up the short wall. They're going to bring in one more player to try to complement that.
Kicked it over the
center.
Wall. Yep. Get them right over the wall. One more, nice kick.
Yeah, one more player down low. Grove City might have had a really sharp opportunity there. And we got another whistle here. More subs coming in from Meadville.
Trying to find a combination to get that tying goal.
That's what you got to do.
Lewandowski back in.
There it goes, 17:57 remaining. Again, both these teams just, Mike, they're giving us a great game. Right now, Grove City with a chance, center, nobody home. I tell you, if nobody home, on D had the right idea. I believe that was Brooke Huff. Is that number 10 on the far side there? Did a nice job. And that's going to be out of bounds. Meadville is going to hurry up and take that.
I like Lewandowski. She gets the ball, she throws it in right away. But the defense can set up. They're smart. Off Meadville here.
And right now, Mattson coming out of the game.
Yes. Maybe just for a few minutes to get her wind going again.
Down on the wallet. There's going to be a whistle. Grove City's going to take advantage of that.
Crowd thought she embellished that a little bit.
Well, the crowd is fickle right now. They want an equalizer.
Yes, they do.
But they're going to have to stay calm. Right now, Grove City.
Grove City's content keeping the ball in the middle.
But, I mean, if you take a look at it, though, I mean, the referees have, in my opinion, have not influenced this game. Got to keep the elbows down.
Yep, a little push there.
That's right. Rich Kiebert saw that one coming in there from Alexis Bannock.
Not a sophomore. Tell me about Meadville sophomore. They like the physical
foot handling here. Alexis Smith and Lassane have been going at it. And that's Lewandowski coming up.
Lewandowski says, "What's wrong? My throwing, isn't it?" She goes, "Yeah, okay."
That's right, and snapping right back up is Alexis
Smith.
Not
a quick change here by Meadville. 27 coming in. Not a sophomore.
That's right, Lindsay Sikorski coming in.
Might have nothing but sophomores out there pretty soon.
I mean, a 2-1 game. That's going to be out of bounds.
Sikorski running up again quickly. She wants to get it in. But Meadville's going to sub again, Lon. Wow.
That's right.
30? Is that 30?
Number 30, yep, that's number 30 coming in the game. That's
the freshman.
Yeah, Jaden Yura coming in.
Wow.
Yurick's going to get right into the play here. Coming up, number 5.
Ooh. Oh, there we go.
Dennis.
Got a chance.
That's right, Yoder has a chance. Lassane breaking in the middle.
Nice move by Yoder.
Gets it back out to the top midfielder. In it goes. No rebound whatsoever from Fulkerson.
Good try by Meadville, though. They set up a nice play.
And 15-minute mark coming down here.
Nice header. Wow, that's a tough play right there. What a nice header, huh?
Big break here from Meadville. They're going to get the free kick.
There you go.
And there's your freshman, Yurick, now.
Yep.
She gets to set her field.
She's got a good leg. I think that's why they put her out there. Look at that leg. Look at that ball. Oh, nice. That was a knuckleball.
Nobody break it to the ball.
That was the thing.
That's a shame. That was like right down to the middle.
She did a good job kicking that. Had a little knuckle on it.
That would have been a nice redirection to anything.
Yes.
Right now, 14:35 remaining. You feel it's getting a little intense here, Mike.
Oh, yeah.
And that's going to go wide and long. And Grove City's going to get a chance to recover. As well they should. It's in the rule book, Mike. I've read it. I'm sure you have not read the rule book.
No, I haven't. I don't know, FIFA, the FIFA's book or?
FIFA, yeah, what's a Sepp Blatter? yeah, you know, you embezzle tens of millions of dollars.
That's
you get a 90-day suspension, that'll be all right.
That's it.
I just hope Sepp Blatter invested, poor guy.
Yeah, feel bad for him.
Yeah, FIFA, what
too bad, too bad Bernie Madoff didn't get his money.
yeah, really. 13:47. Right now, Meadville with the throw-in. That's going to go right to a defender for Grove City. Right now, Grove City just playing two up right now. And Mattson's back in the game.
Oh, yeah, you can't keep her out too long.
No, you cannot.
She got two nice goals, and they were great plays.
Here's Williams right now, toe-to-toe.
Meadville got a nice goal Adams. In this half. Looking to get one more.
I'm telling you again, that matchup between number 14, Alexis Smith, and number 6, Alicia Lassane, has been unbelievable tonight.
For the price of admission, just watching
that's
this
right
play.
13 minutes, Mike, and
look at that time.
Still plenty of time, but
here we go. We got a little break here.
Lassane trying to get it up there to Yoder.
And that's going
to
be a throw-in by there, Meadville, right there. That was a good pass.
That's right. They're going to bring up Yurick now to throw in. Getting a freshman involved right into the action.
Yep. nice throwing too, I think.
That's right, and there's a chance for Meadville. Into the middle goes the Saint, trying to find her way. Can't get around the defense. Stubborn work.
Nice.
Alexis Smith boxing out.
She, though, she used her body well right
there. That's right.
Meadville still coming down that sideline. Can they get it?
Might be stretched too far for Yoder.
She almost hit it off the Grove City kid. That was almost a great play by Yoder.
That's right. We've seen it happen with Grove City on the opposite side. The hustle down low got them the corner.
Yes.
So 12 minutes now. Boy, a minute just went off that fast.
Very little stoppage tonight.
Yes. Absolutely. You're absolutely right.
Not going to have any extra time.
There's a long throw in for Grove City. They'll take advantage of that. Williams. Showing off some foot skills there.
Oh, boy.
And who else but Mattson down. Oh, they're going to call a push there, yeah. Everybody's going to walk away Facebook friends. That's what matters, Mike. Are you on Facebook?
No, but I tell you what.
But you should be.
I tell you what I like, though. Both teams are playing aggressive, but it's not carrying over to anything else.
Nothing wrong with a good physical game.
Not at all. They respect both teams respect them, each other a lot. Even as we said, plenty of young kids out here.
Isn't that the truth? Oh, drop the glasses. Oh, look, somebody left me a mint.
I put that down.
Just like Courtyard by Marriott.
Three. Grove City's only got three seniors, so. Teams are going to get familiar with each other in the next couple of years.
That's right. And where's that one going to go? It's going to go, I think, Grove City's way. Yeah, 10:45 remaining.
Wow.
2-1. Meadville still trying to get that equalizer. By far one of the best high school
soccer matches
I've ever called.
I agree. This is a great game. Both teams are not giving an inch. That's a good kick right there. Great defensive kick back. But if that would have got through, that would have been trouble. To get up high that time to get it past the defense.
That's right. That's going to go out of bounds.
Yes,
Grove City
is
going to get the throw in.
That's where Meadville needs to come up and steal a pass. Find where it's going and get in front of it. Right now.
There's Meadville right there. There's your steal.
Yep.
Again, that's going to float out of bounds in Meadville.
Just the throwing.
Yeah, Lewandowski coming up throwing right now.
Meadville bringing their left side up.
That's right. I see Adams.
We got a switch going on there. A little sub on the fly. Yeah, number. Turn around. That's what you see. Number 11 coming in.
It's going to go right into the Hornet's nest. Right to the Eagle's nest.
Let's go play there. Kick it up high. Oh, they got from Meadville.
There's Adams.
Get in there, Adams. You got a big foot.
Having a nice game. Again, the same might have an opportunity, but nobody down low to help out.
Nope.
Grove City, nice job to clear. Now Yoder coming up. And nothing doing. Mattson back at center field. She says, everybody else play defense, I'll play offense.
I got this girl.
That's right.
That was a smart play right there by Grossi to kick it back to the goalie. She's got a big foot. She kicks it to the side. There was nobody there.
Takes up some time. Takes time to set.
Dasky's got a little bit of information. People can't get anybody in the middle. That's their problem right now.
That's right, and that's going to have to go to Lewandowski again for the throw-in.
Adams, they need to get Adams in the middle with her strong foot.
That's right. Tall, too. She's got a little bit of an advantage. So
that's a good point.
So here's Mattson trying to take on the entire defense again.
Yep.
The Grove City, though, playing a little bit safe.
That's what they're doing. Plenty of time.
That's right, 8 minutes left. That's going to go center.
Spot. That's a good place to kick it.
That's right, Yurik, who's come on strong, the freshman. Here in the second half for Meadville. Again, nice job by Yurik to settle that down.
It was a nice play.
Now Lewandowski looking for room, but Williams. Williams has had a whale of a game for Grove City, number 28 again.
Lewandowski stay with it. if just something comes out of that.
It's going to take one heck of a save, and that's not going to happen.
And now Neal needs to come up on this throw, and they're going to grow something pinned deep here. Come up on this. Is it a throw in or a kick? Let's see.
We're creeping down to 7 minutes.
Oh, it's a kick. All right.
Yeah, they're taking their time, too, so.
Yeah, they're smart.
Yeah, they might outlet it short. Yeah, they do. Grove City taking up more time. Then they'll try the long outlet. And Meadville right there, midfield. Oh, here's
good defensive play by Grove City.
Good hustle back to the ball by Meadville. At number five, Jessica Dennis, she's been hustling all night. Right now, Mike. Almost down to 6.5 minutes here in the second half, 2-1 Grove City.
Yeah, the Eagles got two in the first half, Meadville one here in the second.
Here's a long kick.
That's might right. Be the first shot on goal in about 15 minutes for Grove City.
That's right, Nicolette Fuller. Nice outlet.
Nice kick.
He's got a good foot too. Just impressed with both of them. Cessna and Fuller.
Didn't see anything there, but
yeah. Wow. I needed Lewandowski, apparently. They're going to get a free kick here. No cards have been drawn, though, so.
No, that's right.
Just whistling them down. Now under 6 minutes, Grove City controlling midfield. They're just playing catch right now. And a good job again. Hey, Adam, she's just been interrupting things.
Tough kid.
That gets by. That's what.
Got a chance here. On a little whistle.
Tell you the same. She's just trying to find some room. That's going to roll out of bounds. And Meadville, they just need to hurry up on every opportunity here.
Grove City, definitely in defense mode right now.
Grove City.
Get out of bounds. They're just playing defense.
That's right. Just
sometimes that backfires on.
That's true. You don't want to get too far back on your heels and not apply the pressure. There are Yurks in there right now. 5:53 remaining, folks. 2-1 Grove City still with the lead. They got the throw in far side.
Wow.
That's going to roll downfield.
Wow. Wow.
Yeah, Meadville's going to have to give chase. Oh, out of bounds and a throw in for Grove City.
Yep.
That's kind of tough here with only 4:30 remaining.
If you're a Meadville fan, you can't give up a goal.
I've been hearing the grumbling down low.
Yes.
You know, they're into their girls' soccer here in Meadville.
Yes,
that's a
are.
Great thing.
They know they have a good young team coming, but so does Grove City.
Oh, Meadville, nice job to pick that apart in the middle. They need to outlet. Well, Grove City just
good
tough.
Job.
Coming up, number 35, Corey Potion.
You know, she does a good job.
She's had a nice game tonight, too.
She's just playing in one area and just kicking it.
Okay, everybody has, I think, 78 people in the Meadville stands called that.
Kicks it, and that was a smart play by her.
That's our Mercier trying to keep that one going through, but couldn't settle it down. Now, Lewandowski. 3 minutes, 47 seconds. Right now, everybody's a coach.
Oh, yeah.
Again, there's the best matchup of the night right there. Oh.
Meadville got it back. 3.5 to go. Grove City takes it right back.
That's right, Williams. Good foot handling.
Very good. You know, smart.
Good
kick
ball
back,
handling. Good
kick,
footwork, I should say.
Kick it there. Once on the clock. Get your defense set. There it is. Boom. Boy, Grove City's having a clinic on how to play defense and protect the lead right now.
That's right, coming up on the ball.
As they come up, the defense drives back a little bit.
That's right, that's Lauren Wentz, number 27, also in the game, making her name known. Under 3 minutes now, Mike.
Yep.
In Meadville, you gotta get that upfield in a hurry. Grove City now just stymieing everything in the middle.
Oh,
Mercer trying to get around the defender. can't do it. No, there's going to be a whistle on Mercer. Well, I think people were saying that it was a bad call. Let me tell you what.
That's
a good call.
I'll tell you what. I'm liking the effort by both teams. Their physical play is tremendous. Good. Both of these programs have a good team.
I'm just enjoying the whole atmosphere of the fan base. Everybody
yes.
into the game.
Yep. Both teams backing down from each other.
2 minutes remaining. I tell you, if Meadville gets the
push for the next.
I tell you, there's going to be popcorn on the field, buddy. You're going to see half-eaten hot dogs chucked.
Press box would be rocking.
That's right. Mike is so fired up, they'll invade the fifth ward. You never know what can happen. 145 right now.
Misplay there. This takes
that's
up
right.
a lot of time. And Mundas is going to call for a little bump.
That's right.
You see Meadville's frustration right now. Lon.
And that number eight, Skibinski, is not afraid to get into it from Grove City. Got to see her and her sister. Now, Skibinski, we called her name a lot in the first half.
Look at this kick coming here. This could be a danger play for Meadville. Side kick here.
Yes, it is. Buck 37 remaining. Clock has stopped right now.
Grove City, look at their defense, though.
Back here at the 40. They got, the field right now.
They got five girls from the 40 back still playing defense. Look at their goalie.
I wonder if there's a card on that play. I think there might be.
Is there?
Well, Richie Kiebert's going back to the.
Yeah, and they actually stopped the clock, so you're exactly right. There's an infraction of some sort.
I didn't see the card come out, but now they're getting the substitution in.
Maybe he.
Maybe just wanted his player to cool down a little bit.
Or Rick might be one of these good officials that walks over and shows it like this to the coach. He doesn't want to embarrass the kid.
That's true.
Instead of waving it real high.
They do it rather aggressively in the pro level.
Yeah, you know?
That, like, presentation of the card is like, you know, you can hear the people, no, no, no.
Some FaceTime on TV.
That's right. Right to the middle it goes. Grove City.
They played that defensively. Nice play here.
Try Meadville. They've got a buck 26 to get it up there.
Trying to get it up there. They did.
Yoder in position to take it.
Keep going. Oh, nice.
Good defense interrupt number six.
Yes.
I believe that was Cameron Skibinski. The other Skibinski.
That was a smart play to get her defense back now. 1:10 left. Meadville desperately trying to get it. Oh, that was not a good throw.
Going downfield it goes. Madsen right there in the middle just to be Madsen.
1 minute.
She has both goals for Grove City tonight.
1 minute. Under one.
Let's see what happens here. This could
bounce.
Be a tough handle.
Oh, boy. That's going to be a throwing
opportunity here.
Yep.
50 seconds remaining.
Got to do it quickly. Fox moving. I'd bring everybody up.
Ain't going to hurt nothing at this point.
Pull the goalie.
That's right back. They need a good center. They're not going to get
it. Defense by Crow City.
And that is going to stay in bounds. Look at this. Skibinski coming back.
What a nice play.
Doing the yeoman's work to keep the clock running. 31 seconds left.
Big kick here.
There's Yerk trying to get it up. Can't do it.
And need a strong kick.
Oops. Clanging here.
Crow City taking their time. Why should they hurry to throw it in? 15
right.
seconds.
Hats off both these teams.
Great game.
Grove City coming up here to Meadville and winning this game. Two goals in the first, 13:09 and 2:59. 4-1, Brittany Madsen.
That's it.
Low goal scored by Alicia Sane for Meadville, and that'll do it, folks. What a great game. Absolutely one of the best games I've seen at the high school level.
No doubt about that. You know, Grove City won the first half with two goals. Meadville won the second half. They only got one, so Grove City wins it 2-1. But, Lon, you're exactly right. Spirited.
Highly contested.
Intense game by both sides. Both sides should be.
Now, how do we go home and even explain this to our wives? Because they'll be looking at us like, do you want me to reheat the meatloaf or what? So, anyway, folks, thanks for joining us in Meadville, Grove City. Here on the Armstrong Network, Lon Wilson, Mike Fiorillo. Again, 2-1 Grove City with the win here in Meadville. Have a great night, folks. Take care. Oh, the head across. Oh, what a pickup by the goalkeeper. Are you kidding me, Lassane? There's the mistake they might be waiting for, Mike. Here she is. Shot score. Brittany Madsen, you made the call earlier to keep an eye on her. spread the defense. They got to get back, and there's a center, and in the net it goes. Are you kidding me? Brittany Mattson.
Got a chance.
Got a chance. Same now. Got to go left footed. Shot.
What a great play by Meadville.